The fine weather of Galicia. The sunny side of Spain. No, not really. But I'm not here to talk to you about this. I'm here to talk to you about this. My precious drawing setup. As you can see, it is based upon a do-it-yourself Cintiq knockoff, which is made by an Intus 4 tablet, this small beauty, with R8 hotkeys, of which I don't use these ones because they end up outside my really comfort zone. Not so brilliant twisted pneumatic LCD, and now 15.4 inches, 1440x900 pixels resolution, with not great colors and pretty bad viewing angles. It doesn't eat too much. Also use a cathode tube. It doesn't interfere too much with the working of the tablet, and it suits my necessities at the time, at this time. What else? Well, the Intus has a touch ring that acts as a wheel that I hooked up for the brush size. Also, I usually like to zoom in and out while I draw, so I have conjured another wheel at the side. The wheel itself, this is one of those plastic wheels you find at the bottom of almost all the offices in the world. You buy one set, one piece, it has two of these, this and this one. As you can see, I have one wheel for the zoom. This one, I'm not really sure how it would be best used. For the time, it is hooked to change the active level. So, change the level. Also, as I say, these four hotkeys really ends up outside of my comfort zone. Typically, I keep my hands here, so it can reach easily the sides, the brush sides ring, and the zoom. These are a little on the side for me. Also, the keys from the Intus are pretty hard to patch for my tastes, but they are there. So for changing the active tool, I use this numeric keypad that I have hooked up for doing so. This is for selecting the brush. This is for the bucket, and so on. I place stickers on top of the keys, so I don't have to remember which key is what. The same I did with this keyboard, and so now I have a comprehensive set of hotkeys, way beyond the 8 original in the Intus. How does this thing work? In reality, it works pretty fine. Yes, if you forget the viewing angle not so great, which are really a benediction in disguise for me, because I'm not... I have astigmatism problems, and being forced to work with my eyes straight above the drawing surface have forced me to improve. So, as you can see, it is really pretty usable. A lot more so when I can use two hands for drawing. The main difference of these things and traditional tools is that you can't really draw with one of these things without using both hands. One to actually draw and the other to command the machinery. Error. Yeah, I'm not so much of a straight inker. As you can see, I tend to work a lot in black and white, so the colors are not that much of an issue for me. And there are spots where there is some static jittering. By static, I mean that is some kind of fixed interference. Now, what can I add? In all, I'm happy with this machine that I built myself. The case is mainly wood, which is the reason why I originally called it the Cabinetic, because it's more as an exercise in cabinet making than electronics. Nowadays, I wouldn't probably bother building this thing because, for what it cost me, the ink was. I bought it from the Wacom store, one of their demo staff, and they asked €270. They also gave a 2 years warranty that is worth where I live. But no, for the money that in the end it gobbled up, you can actually buy. In the United States, you can buy an Innova MSP 19U. In Europe, no, because Innova here charges €700 for that thing, $900, almost twice the price for the American public. I don't understand why, but it's their price policy, and so. You can't help. I've seen that there is a tablet monitor from Monoprice at $400. $470 with the shipping from United States to Europe. Which I'm mightily curious to see as to see how it goes, and they are 19 inches. This is a 15.4 inches screen in the end, so it should be more or less this size, the Monoprice and the Innova stuff. There is also the Huion GT190. All of these machines use a UC Logic digitizer, which is pretty good. I have a Huion H610 tablet, and it works pretty well. So nowadays I wouldn't bother building this thing. I will buy or the probably the Monoprice or the Innova. On the other hand, I will buy the Monoprice or the Innova also because now I know how simple it is in the end to overcome one of their weak points, which is the lack of hotkeys. For the people who use hotkeys, it can be a letdown. For me, as you can see, the hotkeys given from the Wacom that I use are this one. All the rest I made myself some way pretty simple. I use a small program called Edit Macros that can hook specific macros or to specific keys of specific keyboards or mouses or whatever. So I hope you got what I was trying to say. I hope my horrible accent didn't scare you. If you think about buying one of these new tablets, remember, hotkeys can be made. It's not that difficult. Goodbye, boys.